Good Wednesday morning. I'm NTV Chief Meteorologist Eddie Shear. Just before 9 a.m. now on this Wednesday, and this is your weather update for the day. As we take a look at some satellite imagery from the GOES East satellite, we can see an abundance of cloud cover across eastern areas of Newfoundland this morning. And as I set the cloud cover here into motion, you can see almost a little bit of a swirl there just to the east of the southern shore. That is a very slow-moving area of low pressure, and that low is helping to drive onshore winds for about the eastern third or even two-thirds of the island this morning, which is why many of us are waking up to some low cloud cover and some fog. The rain that I was thinking may fall overnight looks like it has stayed predominantly to our east. And as I stop this, notice all the texture in the cloud cover here well to the east of Newfoundland over the Grand Banks. That is where the rain is currently located, so we're just kind of in this drizzle and fog pattern for right now, which should try and clear out as we go into the latter part of the morning and the afternoon. Checking in on a couple of webcams, what we can see around St. John's, it is very, very foggy in some areas. As we take a look at this airport webcam, look at that. I am sure flights are having a tough time getting in this morning if you're unlucky enough to be on one. But many areas are kind of stuck in the cloud cover. Shea Heights looking very foggy. But even as we get out toward areas of central Newfoundland, as this loads up, it's pretty foggy in Gander this morning as well. Out into Grand Falls, Windsor, it's cloudy, but it is not foggy. And then looking into the west coast, we are seeing some areas of fog. That's a St. Lunaire Agricka cam. You can see there looking pretty foggy in that area. But not too bad in the Humber Valley Snow Station. Burjo looking a little bit foggy as well this morning, but in the lower Humber area of Steady Brook, not too far away from Corner Brook and Marble Mountain, we're not looking too bad as we kind of start off the day. Into Labrador, Goose Bay are not looking too bad this morning, and Wabush were dry for now, but that is going to change. Some very heavy rainfall is potentially on the way for Labrador from later today through tonight, through Thursday, and even Friday. And I was mentioning that yesterday. And because of that threat, Environment Canada has issued a special weather statement for the Churchill Valley, Churchill Falls, Labrador City and Wabush, Post Hopedale and vicinity, as well as Nain and vicinity. And the warning text basically says here that heavy rainfall is expected. A low pressure system approaching Labrador from the west will bring rain to western and northern sections of the Big Land beginning today. The rain is expected to be heavy at times, anywhere from 25 to 50 millimeters in the forecast before the rain tapers off Thursday afternoon or Thursday evening. And this is something I was indeed mentioning yesterday. And as far as the rainfall forecast goes, the computer guidance was showing some pretty prolific amounts yesterday. Now today, it looks like the rainfall amounts for Lab West have come down a bit. And as we take a look at that latest rainfall forecast for Lab City, notice computer model guidance, each one of these that you're seeing here, RGM, Euro, GFS, RPM1, RPM2, those are all different computer models, and they're deterministic models, meaning they're just one run. You can run multiple versions of these models called ensembles, and they sometimes give you more accurate forecasts. But for all intents and purposes, this is pretty good, as they're all in pretty good agreement that rainfall in Lab City between later today and Friday morning will be somewhere between 50 and 60 millimeters, which is better than what it was showing yesterday. Yesterday, the forecast was for close on 100 millimeters in some spots, so glad to see that is beginning to drop. As far as temperatures go across the province this morning, as we load that up for you, we can see it's definitely feeling a little bit more humid out there. We're 15 St. John's, but a humidex of 19. Same thing in Gander, Badger, it's 9, but we are seeing some fog out that way. Corner Brook, we're looking at 14. And then to Labrador, temperatures along the coast are into the single numbers. In the west, we are into the teens at this hour. As we take a look at Futurecast for today, we see the swirl here. That is our area of low pressure. As that begins to kind of pull away, we will see some breaks in the cloud across eastern Newfoundland, but I think that won't happen until this afternoon. Notice those wind streamlines staying northerly or easterly. So when that happens, we tend to get a lot of low cloud cover for many areas of eastern Newfoundland. But I think as we go through the afternoon, as the low pulls away, winds will turn more westerly or southwesterly, which should allow for some sunny breaks across the island, temperatures into the teens and 20s. Nicest weather today by far going to be along the West Coast and at Northern Peninsula. And then as we do get into this evening, we see temperatures staying into the teens for many areas of eastern Newfoundland, falling into the teens for the West Coast. And there's that rain pushing into Labrador by this evening, becoming heavy at times as we head into the overnight. So we'll talk more about that rain threat for western Labrador coming up in just a bit. But I also, or coming up tonight, I should say, I always forget that I'm not on TV when I'm doing these at home. But what I also want to show you is the computer model rainfall forecast for Labrador as we go between the next couple of days. Notice that bullseye right in Lab West, which is showing between roughly 40 and 60 millimeters of rain. So that's what it looks like. Lesser amounts as we go farther north, where rainfall amounts look like they are going to be between 20 and 40 millimeters, and lesser amounts yet as we get into southeastern Labrador. Also notice some of these higher totals for southern areas of Newfoundland. That rain comes in on Friday, and it looks like eastern areas may see some significant rainfall on Friday, but things do look like we kind of try and clear out for Sunday. So that's how it looks right now. Have a great day. I will see you this evening on NTV starting at 5:30 on First Edition, and then between 6 and 7 on the Evening News Hour. And before then, as always, on social media, be sure to check out my channels at Eddie Shear on Twitter, Meteorologist Eddie Shear on Facebook, and you can find me on Instagram as well, Eddie Shear there. Same thing on Snapchat. Have a great day, and I'll see you this evening.